Brothers and sisters, there are a couple of elements pertaining to Al-Qasam, which we have been doing for the last 2 days. I'll explain them to you today, inshallah. We have seen before the introduction of Qasam to a shart. And the introduction is done by using the letter Lam, Lain. And this Lam, as I told you, is called Lam Al-Mutiyah or Al-Mu'attiyah Lil-Qasam, the Lam that paves the way for the Qasam. So it stands for Wallahi or Uqsimu. And when there's a combination of qasam and shart, the jawab confirms to the qasam and not to the shart. And we have seen examples of this phenomenon in a number of ayat. Now, I would like to mention that this lam can be omitted. But it's not very frequent, but only in 3 ayat we have, it has been omitted. And when it is omitted, how do we find out? We find out from the jawab. The jawab does not conform to shart. Then it should be the jawab of qasam. For example, in this, the first ayah we have, وَإِنَّ الشَّيَاطِينَ لَيُوحُونَ إِلَىٰ أَوْلِيَائِهِمْ لِيُجَادِلُوكُمْ وَإِنَّ الشَّيَاطِينَ شَيَاطِينَ plural of shaitan وَإِنَّ الشَّيَاطِينَ لَيُوحُونَ لام, this lam is lam اللام المزهلقة. Indeed the satans, the devils, لَيُوحُونَ inspire أَوْحَى يُوحِي singular يُوحِي and plural is يُوحُونَ. Awha is past tense. We have seen this the verb many times. Awha yuhi. Awha is which bab?
Fourth.
Bab fourth. Awha yuhi. La yuhuna. This lam 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 al muzahalaka. La yuhuna. They inspire or they suggest to their allies. Awliya in waliyun. Awliya. Of course, awliya means their human beings. Who are their agents, agents of the devils. يُوحُونَ إِلَىٰ أَوْلِيَائِهِمْ لِيُجَادِلُوكُمْ جَادَلَ يُجَادِلُ. Which bab is this?
Form
3. جَادَلَ يُجَادِلُ. What are the two masdars? جِدَالٌ and مُجَادَلَةٌ. مُجَادَلَةٌ. جَادَلَ يُجَادِلُ. مُجَادِلُونَ. اسم الفاعل جا دالا مصدر is جدال and مجادلة جا دالا يجادل جدال and مجادلة لِيُجَادِلُوكُمْ to dispute with you. This ayah, the part of the ayah which precedes this is about eating, not eating animals not slaughtered in the name of Allah. إِنَّهُ فِسْقٌ, it is abominy. وَإِنَّ الشَّيَاطِينَ لِيُوحُونَ إِلَىٰ أَوْلِيَائِهِمْ لِيُجَادِلُوكُمْ. Indeed, the satans, the devils, suggest to their allies to dispute with you. وَإِنْ أَتَعْتُمُوهُمْ وَإِنْ أَتَعْتُمُوهُمْ. And if you obey them, إِنَّكُمْ لَمُشْرِكُونَ. Indeed, you are mushrik. إِنَّكُمْ لَمُشْرِكُونَ. Now here, in ata'atum, this is shart. Innakum, jawab shart, is a jumla ismiya, and it should have what?
Fa.
So if it is jawab shart, it must have fa. So it cannot be jawab shart because there is no fa. That means it is jawab al qasam, and the lam has to be supplied in your mind. Wa in wala in ata'atumuhum. Wala in ata'atumuhum. إِنَّكُمْ لَمُشْرِكُونَ. Is that clear? Yes. You can easily find out that it does not conform to جَوَابُ الشَّرْطِ. It must be جَوَابُ الْقَسَمِ. Now, second, we'll come to that a little later. The third ayah, we have seen part of this ayah before yesterday, but I have written it completely now. أَلَمْ تَرَ إِلَى الَّذِينَ نَافَقُوا يقولون لإخوانهم الذين كفروا من أهل الكتاب لئن خرجتم لنخرجن معكم. ألم ترى إلى الذين نافقوا. نافقوا, which verb is this? Yes, three. فاعل. What is the مصدر? نافقا. نافقا نفاق. نفاق, you know this word is known to you. نفاق. منافقة can also be used, but that is less frequently used. But this is the word نفاق. That is, as you know, historically, these are the people who were in Medina. When the Prophet ﷺ migrated to Medina, they were a group of people who did not, who believe in the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but they treated as if they were Muslims. They are the munafiqun. They showed themselves to be Muslims, but they were not Muslims. Abdullah ibn Ubay, yes, Way ibn Salul, Habla. Those people, they are the munafiqun. Alladhina nafaqu. Alladhina nafaqu. Alam tara ila alladhina nafaqu. Did you see those who were hypocrites, munafiqun? Yaquluna li ikhwanihim alladhina kafaru. Saying to their brothers who did not believe, who were disbelievers, min ahlil kitabi, from the people of the book. That is, some of them had believed, others had not believed. So these are the people who had not believed from the people of the book. إِخْوَانِهِمْ الَّذِينَ. إِخْوَان here in the sense of associates, allies. إِخْوَانِهِمْ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا مِنْ أَهْلِ الْكِتَابِ لَئِنْ أُخْرِجْتُمْ. We read this yesterday. لَئِنْ أُخْرِجْتُمْ, if you are deported from the city, لَنَخْرُجَنَّ مَعَكُمْ, we will also go out with you. وَلَا نُطِيعُ فِيكُمْ أَحَدًا أَبَدًا, and we will not obey anyone with regard to you. فِيكُمْ, with regard to you. We have seen this before also. With regard to you, we will not obey anyone ever. أَبَدًا. Abadan, as we have seen, is a word to emphasize the negative particle. In the future, in the past, what do we use? Qattu. Ma ra'aytuhu qattu, never saw him. And in the future we say, lan adhaba ilayhi abadan, I will never go there. So lan adhaba ilayhi, to him. So in future, abadan, in past, qattu. I think it's in the book. Wala nuti'u fikum ahadan abadan. Wa in qutiltum. Yesterday we did this, but I did not mention this to you. Wa in qutiltum. There is no lam here. وَلَا إِن قُوتِلْتُمْ. وَلَا إِن قُوتِلْتُمْ, if you are, if, war is made against you. Qatala, which bab? Bab 3. Qatala yuqatilu, masdar. Qitalun and muqatalatun. Qitalun and muqatalatun. Wa in qutiltum. If war is made against you, lanansurannakum, we will support you. Nasara, to help and to support. The meaning is to support, that is the word. In Indian subcontinent, I have seen many people using this word even for helping. Please help me. So if you want to carry this table, they will say, Sa'idini, Sa'ada, Yusa'idu, Musa'adatun, Sa'idini. But there you don't use unsurni. Nasara is to support someone, everyone's cause. وَإِن قُوتِلْتُمْ لَنَنْصُرَنَّكُمْ لَنَنْصُرَنَّكُمْ We will support you. If war is waged against you, we will support you. وَاللَّهُ يَشْهَدُ إِنَّهُمْ لَكَاذِبُونَ وَاللَّهُ يَشْهَدُ شَهِدَ يَشْهَدُ Which bab is this? سَمِعَ يَسْمَعُ شَهِدَ يَشْهَدُ شَهِدٌ شَهَادَةٌ مَزَرِ شَهَادَةٌ Please note here, وَاللَّهُ يَشْهَدُ Allah bears witness. And then we have إِنَّهُمْ Not أَنَّهُمْ The usual in the adhan we say ashhadu an shahada ashhadu an la ilaha an and you have read in the book that inna comes only after qala inni abdullah after other verbs we use anna but here we have wallahu yashhadu innahum lakadhibun the reason for this is that shahida yashhadu here has a double meaning of swearing. Allah swears, Allah swears, or takes an oath, shahida. I had occasion to mention you the word at-tadmeen. At-tadmeen. This is a masdar of dhammana. This is a linguistic trick in where a word is given the meaning of another word. It takes two meanings. How do we know that? We know it from the next word, from the surrounding of this word. That it has I told you litaskunu ilayha when we read the surah ar-rum litaskunu ilayha sakana does not take ila but yeah taskunu ilayha I told you it means litamilu ilayha so that you incline towards so that is tadmeen it has been given another meaning We have got many examples of that in the Quran. So here, Yashhadu has got, in addition to its original meaning of to bear witness, another meaning, which is to swear. And that is why swearing has to take inna. Wallahi inna. So, wal yashhadu innahum lakadhibun. Allah bears witness or Allah swears, innahum lakadhibun, they are liars. And if you have anna, you can't have lam. Lam goes with what? Lam al-muzahalaqa? With inna. For arifu annaka, there you can't say arifu annaka talibun. I know you are a student. Here you can't say arifu annaka la talibun, you can't say. So lam of it is part of inna. It is used with the khabar of inna. Because inna signifies emphasis, and lam also signifies emphasis. They do go together. So here you got this in Surah Al-Munafiqun also, you find yashhadu being used in the sense, in addition to bearing witness, swearing. Wallahu yashhadu innahum lakadhibun. To make a note of this, yashhadu, you may ask, somebody may ask you, why yashhadu inna and not anna? So here yashhadu has a meaning, additional meaning of swearing, and that is why the next word has inna with a kasra. Now we go back to ayah number 2. قَالَا رَبَّنَا ظَلَمْنَا أَنفُسَنَا وَإِنْ لَمْ تَغْفِرْ لَنَا وَتَرْحَمْنَا لَنَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. قَالَا 2 Alif, Alif al-Muthanna. قَالَا, they said. The pronoun refers to Adam alayhi salam and Hawa alayhi salam. قَالَا رَبَّنَا. Rabbana is what? What? Munada. Munada mudaf. Munada mudaf. As you say, Ya Rabbal Ka'bati. Rabbul Ka'bati. Rabbal Ka'bati. Imamuna, our Imam, you will say, Ya Imamana. Akhuna, how do you say Ya?
Ya
Akhana. Akhuna, Ya Akhana. Because Akhu is مرفوع and أخانَ, if it is مضاف, it takes ألف. يا أخانَ, يا أبا بكرٍ, أبو بكرٍ, يا أبا بكرٍ. So مضاف, منادى مضاف. قَالَ رَبَّنَا ظَلَمْنَا أَنفُسَنَا. We have wronged ourselves. ظَلَمْنَا, ظَلَمَ يَظْلِمُ, ظُلْمٌ. ظَلَمْنَا أَنفُسَنَا. I'll come back to this word أَنفُسَنَا a little later. وَإِنْ لَمْ تَغْفِرْ لَنَا, if you do not forgive us, وَإِنْ لَمْ تَغْفِرْ, that is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they are telling Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, إِنْ لَمْ تَغْفِرْ لَنَا وَتَرْحَمْنَا and have mercy on us, لَنَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ, we will be the, among the losers, we will be the loser, we will be in loss. Now here, إِنْ لَمْ تَغْفِرْ لَنَا, yes, لَتَكُونَنَّ does not go with a shart, you follow me? Yeah, so it must be لَإِن, لَإِن لَمْ تَغْفِرْ لَنَا وَتَرْحَمْنَا لَنَكُونَّ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. So easily you can find out, because the khabar is here, لَتُكُونَنَّ. If it were جواب of شرط, it would be like this, وَإِن لَمْ تَغْفِرْ لَنَا وَتَرْحَمْنَا نَكُن. You follow me? مجزوم, it will be نَكُن من الخاسرين. إن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا نكون. نكون, and if it is مجزوم, the waw will be lost because of التقاء الساكنين, you say نكون. So إن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا, if it is جواب الشرط, we say نكون من الخاسرين. But it is not like this. It is لنكونن. So it is jawab al qasam. So in these three ayat, lam al-lam al-muti'a lil qasam has been omitted, and there is clear indication in the jawab that the jawab belongs to al qasam and not to khabar. Now there is a note about anfusana. Qala rabbana zalamna. Zalamna, how many people are involved? Two. And you have anfusana. Nafsun is self, and the two will be nafsani, and plural is anfusun. Anfusun. So the point here is there are two, but the plural anfus has been used. Now, that's the correct way of using this. I'll explain to you in a little detail. مثلا, for example, غسل غسل الرجل وجهه The man washed his face. غسل الرجل وجهه Now we let us make it مثنى غسل of course remains as it is غسل الرجلان غسل الرجلان you will say وجوههما we won't say غسل الرجلان وجهيهما one would expect to say وجهيهما when do we say this when we know that there is only one thing that we are talking about you know what I mean face only one face you know what I mean yes But we won't say, for example, with regard to a son, جَعَلْ رَجُلَانِ بِأَبْنَائِهِمَا If you don't, if it's only one son, each one came with a son, because we don't know, he may have more sons. So with regard to head, face, and chest, yeah, things we are known, nafs, that it is only one, and there's no ambiguity, it's the correct way is to use the plural. Correct way is to use the plural. I'll give another example from the Quran. In Surah Tahrim, in Tatuba, فَقَدْ صَغَتْ قلوبكما إن تتوبا فقد صغت قلوبكما You read in Surah Tahrim to why was the Prophet there was some quarrel so Allah says إن تتوبا if you Repent, both of you. The jawab is فَقَدْ صَغَتْ قُلُوبُكُمَا Actually, the meaning is in Tatuba, if you repent, it is better. It is better. فَهُوَ أَحْسَنُ It is better. فَقَدْ صَغَتْ قُلُوبُكُمَا Your hearts have deviated. صَغَا سِنْ غَيْنْ يَا صغت فقد صغت قلوبكما قلوبكما not قلوبكما plural that is the correct way of saying there is another ayah السارق والسارقة فاقطعوا أي ذي هما السارق والسارقة فاقطعوا أيديهما The thief, male and female السارق سرق سارق يسرق You know this word سارق السارق والسارقة فاقطعوا cut top off أيديهما their hands Not all the hands. Only one hand goes. So, yadun, yadun, two. They should not yadayihima, but the, as I told you, according to this rule, use a plural. Aydiyahuma, it means only one hand from each of these two. Saga, as I told you, to deviate. Your hearts have deviated from the right path.
فقد صغت قلوبكما.
These fine points you may not find in textbooks, yes. So please note this. قَالَ رَبَّنَا ظَلَمْنَا أَنفُسَنَا. So please here note this is Quranic, not only Quranic, but that is the correct way. It should be plural. But when there is ambiguity, you have to use the مثنى. In words which may have ambiguity. But here, قَلْب, everyone has only one قَلْب. Head, only one, everybody has one head. Indian gods have many. قال ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. Yes. We go back to the ayah of that. Yesterday we read لمن تبع. You remember this ayah? لَمَنْ تَبِعَكَ مِنْهُمْ لَأَمْلَأَنَّ جَهَنَّمَ مِنْكُمْ أَجْمَعِينَ. In second page, لَمَنْ, I told you, this لام is لام الموتي للقسم. مَنْ شرطية. With لام, لام اللام الموتي للقسم. لَمَنْ تَبِعَكَ مِنْهُمْ لَأَمْلَأَنَّ جَهَنَّمَ مِنْكُمْ أَجْمَعِينَ. That is, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks to the Satan, addresses the Satan, he says, لَمَنْ تَبِعَكَ, he who yes, follows you, مِنْهُمْ, from them, لَأَمْلَأَنَّ جَهَنَّمَ, I will fill the hell, مِنْكُمْ, fill the heavens with you, all of you, all together. So مِنْكُمْ is the devil and the those who follow. So لَمَنْ, لَمْ, this لَمْ الْمُوتِيَ لِلْقَسَمْ, please note. And here we have another ayah, وَلَمَنْ صَبَرَ وَغَفَرَ. وَلَمَنْ, this is also لام اللام الموطية للقسم. وَلَمَنْ صَبَرَ وَغَفَرَ. Whoever has patience and forgives his brothers, fellow Muslims, whoever got صَبَرَ وَغَفَرَ, if he has done, if wrong is done to him, he has patience and then forgives his enemy. Allah says, وَلَمَنْ صَبَرَ وَغَفَرَ إِنَّ ذَٰلِكَ لَمِنْ عَزْمِ الْأُمُورِ. That is actually really a matter which requires determination. لَعَزْمِ الْأُمُورِ, a matter requiring determination. Well, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala extols this act. وَلَمَنْ صَبَرَ. So you got لَمِنْ, secondly. First we have got وَلَمَنْ. So مَنْ شَرْطِيَّ with the لام الموتي للقسم. And إِنَّ ذَلِكَ لَمِنْ. This is لام اللام المزهلقة. Yes. من عزم الأمور, acts that require determination. The ayah after that, we'll come to that later. It is not connected with Qasam. The word here in these three ayahs, I wanted to mention to you that the word Aqsama, in the Quran we have La Uqsimu, we have read in the final eighth lesson, La Uqsimu, yes, بهذا البلد. Aqsama, La Uqsimu, this is Mudare, Aqsama Yuqsimu. In the Quran, the past tense Aqsama is also used. يقسم, أقسم, يقسم, مضارع is also used. Here we have an example of وَأَقْسَمُوا, past tense. إِذْ أَقْسَمُوا. The whole ayah is إِنَّا بَلَوْنَاهُمْ كَمَا بَلَوْنَا أَصْحَابَ الْجَنَّةِ. I'll write the ayah. It's better to understand the whole ayah. إِنَّا بَلَوْنَاهُمْ كَمَا بَلَوْنَا أَصْحَابَ الْجَنَّةِ inna balawnahum kama balawna ashabal jannati. This is in Surah Al-Qalam. Inna balawnahum kama balawna ashabal jannati. Idh balawna bala yablu. What is bala means? To test. Yes. Test by tribulation. So bala yablu. We also have bab iftala, ibtala yabtali. Bab 8, ibtala yabtali. But bala is the first class of Mujarrad, bala yablu. Wala nabluwannakum. In the Quran, wala nabluwannakum will test you. Inna balawnahum. We tested them. That is the people of Mecca, the unbelievers of Mecca. Inna balawnahum kama balawna ashab al jannah. As we tested the people of the garden. This is not paradise here. Jannah. There was a garden, people who owned a garden, then they went in and they wanted to have harvest without anybody knowing that they are harvesting, so that, you know, they have not to share it with the poor. And then the whole thing was burned down, something. So, inna balawnahum kama balawna, kama. This ma is what? Maal mazdariya. Kama balawna. As we have told in the book, uktub kama yaktubul mudarris. Write as a teacher writes. That means, uktub ka kitabatil mudarris. Write like the teacher's writing. So, kama yaktubu with ma and the next word, it's meaning of masdar. Inna balawnahum kama balawna ashab al jannah. Ashaba maf'ul bihi. Plural, the object of balawna, ashab, balawnahum kama balawna ashab al jannati garden. Idh. What is idh here? What is it? Maful fi, warf. We have seen that. Is when it is used with the past tense, with the maldi. When, I think we've done in the one of the lessons here. Is aqsamu, when they swore, aqsamu. Is aqsamu la yasrimunnaha musbihin. Is aqsamu, they swore. Now this is jawab al-qasam, la yasrimunnaha. Sarama yasrimu is to harvest, to cut the harvest, to cut the plant for harvesting. Sarama yasrimu, which bab is this? Daraba yadru. Sarama yasrimu. يَصْرِمُنَّهَا إِذْ أَقْسَمُوا لَيَصْرِمُنَّهَا مُصْبِحِينَ لَيَصْرِمُنَّهَا. The pronoun refers to Jannah. لَيَصْرِمُنَّهَا, the garden. They will harvest the plant in the garden, the produce in the garden. لَيَصْرِمُنَّهَا مُصْبِحِينَ. What is the Arab musbahim of musbihin? Yes, what is the Arab?
It's
hal. Hal. So, yasrimunnaha musbihin. Hal. When they are in the morning. Asbaha yusbihu. Ismul fa'il musbih. This is asbaha. We tam verb. It's not the naqis which takes ism and khabar. It is the tam which takes fa'il. Asbaha, asbahtu. I entered the morning. I spent the morning. Yusbih musbihin, when they enter the morning. That is the They said, we will harvest the produce in the morning so that nobody knows, and they wanted to deprive the poor of the share. إذ أقسموا إنا بلوناهم كما بلونا أصحاب الجنة إذ أقسموا ليصرمنها مصبحين. Now this is Aqsama, Bab 4. It is also used in Bab 3, Qasama. Qasama means two people, as we know, Bab Fa'ala is reciprocal action. Reciprocal action. كاتبته, I wrote to him, he wrote to me. Corresponded, we corresponded. نحن نكاتب, نحن نكاتب, we write to each other. وقاسمهما. So he offered an oath to them. هما refers to Adam عليه السلام and Hawa عليه السلام. وقاسمهما. That is, he told them, swearing. وَقَاسَمَهُمَا إِنِّي لَكُمَا لَمِنَ النَّاصِحِينَ. I am a well-wisher to you, one of the well-wishers. نَصَحَ يَنْصَحُ بَفَعَلَ يَفْعَلُ نَصَحَ يَنْصَحُ نَاصِحٌ نَاصِحٌ إِنِّي لَكُمَا I am to you لمن الناصحين. Here you have إنا and لام اللام المزهلقة. إني لكما لمن الناصحين. ناصحين نصحا نصحت. Please note that نصحا, you can say نصحته, I advised him, or you can say نصحت له. نصحت له, this is more frequently used in the Quran. It is always, I think, نصحت له. Here also إِنَّ لَكُمَا مِنَ النَّاصِحِينَ. So نَصَحْتُ لَهُ means I gave him an advice. So نَاصِح means well-wisher, one who tries to help by giving him the correct opinion about a matter. وَقَاسَمَهُمَا إِنِّي لَكُمَا لَمِنَ النَّاصِحِينَ. You can also use تَقَاسَمَا. تقاسما is also reciprocal, like تعاونا, to cooperate. Cooperate, that is, you help him and he helps you. But the difference between فعلا and تفعلا, and فعلا, فعلا takes object. Like صافحا, to shake hand. صافحت بلالا, I shook hand with بلال. صافحت بلالا. But تصافحا, so the two subjects, two فاعل. There is more than one فاعل, but there is no object. تصافح الناس, people shook hands. تصافح الناس, it is intransitive, it doesn't take مفعول به. But if you say صافح, it takes مفعول. You say صافحت محمدا, صافحت الضيفة, I shook hands with the guest. You follow me? But تصافحنا, we shook hands, yes. It doesn't need مفعول به. So تقاسم وقالوا تقاسموا بالله لنبيتنه وأهله ثم لنقولن لوليه ما شهدنا مهلك أهله وإنا لصادقون. This is about صالح عليه السلام, the prophet صالح, ثمود صالح, who lived in Madain. So even today we have this place where this nation lived, Madain Saleh. It's called Madain Saleh, Medina plural Madain, Madain Saleh, where you have these rocks with houses made, hewn out of the huge rocks. Even today they are preserved. No, in Saudi Arabia. Yeah, Al-Ula, there is a small town called Al-Ula. It's near this, outside this town, Al-Ula. Madain Saleh. But in Jordan they have Petra, it looks like that, it's also. وقالوا تقاسموا بالله. They said, make an oath, take an oath. تقاسموا. This is Amr. تقاسموا بالله. In Allah's name, of course they believed in Allah. تقاسموا بالله. All of you take an oath in Allah's name. What for? لَنُبَيِّتَنَّهُ وَأَهْلَهُ. بَيَّتَ. بَيَّتَ, which verb is this? بَيَّتَ. Form 2, بَيَّتَ يُبَيِّتُ. بَيَّتَ يُبَيِّتُ. Yes. بَيَّتَ, you know, بَاتَ, we have بَاتَ. It is connected with the word bait. Bata yabitu. This is one of the sisters of Kana. One of the, please know, this is in the Quran, used many times. Bata, one of the sisters of Kana. We have learned Asbaha, Asbaha to become in the morning. Amsa to become in the evening. Bata means to become at night. To become at night. So it takes isman khabar just like Kana, just like Asbaha. We say Asbaha Muhammadun Maridan. He was sick in the morning. Amsa Bilalun Nashitan. Bilal became active in the evening. Bata Bilalun Maridan. He was at night, he was sick at night. Bilal spent the night as a sick man. So Bata Bilalun Maridan. First person I, how do you say? Bittu. Yeah. Bittu. Bittu. Bittu fil masjidi. I spent the night in the mosque. Bittu fil masjidi. Bittu. Bata. Yabitu. In Surah Al-Furqan. Yes? Yabituna lirabbihim sujjadam. وقياما يبيتون لربهم والذين يبيتون لربهم سجدا ساجد ساجد plural سجد. So they spend the night in sajda. والذين يبيتون لربهم سجدا وقياما and standing. قائم plural قيام ساجد سجد. So they spend the night standing and performing sajda. So Bata, please remember, it is one of the sisters of Kana. It is one of the series of this Asbaha series. Asbaha, Amsa in the evening. And Walla. Walla is during the day. Walla Yawallu. That is Bab Fa'ila Yaf'al. Walla. يظل. You see, for example, ظل الجو حارا. ظل الجو حار. The weather was hot during the day, not on the morning. ظل الجو حارا اليوم. Today, the weather was hot during the day. وبات الجو باردا. وبات الجو باردا. The weather was cold in the at night. So walla during the day and bata during the night. Asbaha during the morning and amsa during the evening. So these are all connected with time bound. So we say qalu taqasamu billahi lanubayyitannahu bayyata. Bata is the Mujarrad. Bayyata, bafa'ala. Bayyata means to attack at night. To attack at night. Attacking at night is easier. I believe. وَلَنُبَيِّتَنَّهُ لَنُبَيِّتَنَّهُ They تَقَالُوا تَقَاسَمُوا take an oath all together بِاللَّهِ in the name of Allah لَنُبَيِّتَنَّهُ we will attack him at night لَنُبَيِّتَنَّهُ صَالِحَ عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامِ لَنُبَيِّتَنَّهُ لُبَيِّتَنَّهُ وَأَهْلَهُ and his family not him alone ثُمَّ لَنَقُولَنَّ لَقُولَنَّ and then we'll say لِوَلِيِّهِ to the next of kin وَلِيٌّ ثُمَّ لَنَقُولَنَّ I can easily tell the next of kin مَا شَهِدْنَا مَهْلِكَ أَهْلِهِ مَا شَهِدْنَا مَهْلِكَ حَلَكَ يَهْلِكُ And Mahlik is Mazdar Mimi. Mazdar Mimi. That is the destruction. Halaka Yahliku. Ma Shahidana. Here Shahidana means what? We did not witness, we did not see. Ma Shahidana Mahlika Ahlihi. We did not see the destruction of his family. He and his family, of course. وَإِنَّا لَصَادِقُونَ And verily we are, indeed we are truthful. We are telling the truth. We did not notice when he died and who killed him. We didn't know. So we can easily, at night, nobody will notice us and we can do away with him and tell the people that we did not. So وَقَالُوا تَقَاسَمُوا بِاللَّهِ تَقَاسَمُوا بِاللَّهِ لَنُبَيِّتَنَّهُ We will kill him at night. وَأَهْلَهُ and his people and his household ثُمَّ لَنَقُولَنَّ لِوَلِيِّهِ and then we tell his next of kin مَا شَهِدْنَا مَهْلِكَ أَهْلِهِ مَهْلِك please remember this is مَصْدَر مَصْدَر مِيمِ هَلَكَ يَهْلِكُ مَهْلِك أَهْلِهِ وَإِنَّا لَصَادِقُونَ and we are telling the truth so these three forms أَقْسَمَ قَاسَمَ تَقَاسَمَ all are used in the Quran And the most frequently used is aqsama, fourth. Aqsama used in past tense also mudara and also mudara. La uqsimu billahi, la uqsimu. Number of surahs start with la uqsimu, biyawm al-qiyamah, la uqsimu. The masdar is qasam. Masdar is qasamun. And they told you also yameenun. Plural aymanun is also another important word used in the Quran. Aqsamu jahda aymanihim. They swore their strongest oaths. Another word used in the Quran which I have not mentioned is halafa yahlifu. This also means to swear. Halafa yahlifu. Yes, to Hilf. Hilf means swearing and also it means a pact because in pact you agree to do something with a swearing. Hilf natu. Hilf natu. What does it mean? NATO pact. Hilf NATO. Hilf is a pact. We are finished with this. And alhamdulillah, most of the things that are connected with Qasam, we have done. It's a very important grammatical element. And I don't think there are the grammatical books, you know, grammar books deal in such detail with all the details that I have mentioned. So please remember this because it's a very important thing in the Quran. There are lots and lots of examples of القسم and جواب القسم لام اللام الموطية للقسم and the omission of this lam all this inshallah it will help you to understand the Quran better inshallah. Now there are a couple of grammatical elements which I have not mentioned in the book but which are important for you to know. I'll mention them. Bigger pardon? Ah, yes. Yes. وَيَسْتَنْبِئُونَكَ أَحَقٌ هُوَ. That one. There's no qasam here, but I wanted to tell you this for some other reason. No, there is qasam. Here, وَيَسْتَنْبِئُونَكَ. يَسْتَنْبِئُونَكَ. What verb is this? Tenth. Istambaa yastambiu. What is the basic word? Nabaun is news. Yes. News. Nabaun. Ambaun. Plural of Nabaun is Ambaun. Suratun Naba. Amma yatasaalun anin Naba'il Azim. Anin Naba'il Azim. Naba is news. Istamba, as you know, istafala, bab 10th, means to seek information, to seek something. So it is istamba means sought information. Sought information. There's another word, istalama. This is a word used in Arab countries nowadays. Istalama from what? Alima. Alima ya'lamu, to know. Istalama, to seek knowledge. Istalama, seek information. You'll find the board isti'lam. Isti'lamat, plural isti'lamat, means information. Where you can go and ask the man sitting there about what you want to know. Where to go and where to what to write. Isti'lam. Isti'lamat also is usually written in plural. Isti'lamat. Isti'lamat. Masdar of isti'lama. Isti'lamat. So istamba'a has the same meaning. To seek information. Yastambi'unaka ahaqqun huwa. They seek information. They ask you. Ahaqqun huwa. Is it truth? Is it truth? Is it the truth or is it true? Ahaqqun huwa. Ahaqqun huwa. Where is the mubtada? Huwa. Ahaqqun huwa. Qul e wa rabbi. Now I just want to tell you this. E comes before qasam. Yes, by my Lord. It is a word used only with qasam. It comes before the qasam. It's only one ayah where the word E has been used. But it has an importance which I will tell you a little later, inshallah. Yes, a strong qasam. Qul E wa rabbi. Yes, by my Lord. Innahu lahaqqun. It is the truth. It is true. وَيَسْتَنْبِئُونَكَ أَحَقٌ هُوَ. Qul E wa rabbi. إي وربي إنه لحق. This is جواب القسم. إن and لام المزحلقة. ويستنبئونك أحق هو قل إي وربي. This word إي وربي. Or you can say, for example, E wallahi. E wallahi, E wa rabbi. So it goes before qasam, is used with the qasam, it comes before the qasam. Beg your pardon?
Yeah, there should be dots and
sukun. You see, as I told you, dhabt, there are different systems of dhabt. In India, in Indian subcontinent, the long vowels have sukun. Qu will have vowel of sukun. Fi, ya will have sukun. But in the Arab system, no. As I told you, there are different systems of dhabt. So there are systems we don't write on the vowels, long vowels, no sukun. Now this is a very interesting thing about this. If you note this, if you pronounce E plus wa and do not mention the name of Allah. For example, here, E, stop there, E, wa. This is the word which the Arabs in their dialects use for yes, na'am. Most Arabs use I, wa with fatha. But in the countryside, especially in Egypt, they say E, wa. E, wa. Which is actually E wallahi. Probably they did not mention the name of Allah for respect. They dropped it and they said Ewa. The word for yes in almost all the Arab countries, dialects, they say Ewa or Aiwa. In the cities they say Aiwa, in the countryside they say Ewa. And the countryside pronunciation is the correct one.